Bhushan, World Music Day seems like a perfect time to sit down with Bollywood's music mogul. I read that T-Series has 70% of the Indian music market and you have the largest viewed YouTube channel in the world.
Saying that we are the largest music label in India or in Asia will be very, means I don't like to say that always. Yes, but because of our content strength, we are very big on YouTube. And
billions of views.
Yeah, billions of views, and means at one point of time we were number one channel in the world in terms of views, and in terms of subscription we were number two. So which is a very, very big achievement, and this all happens just because of great content. So we are very proud, not in a very egoistic way, but as a whole team, means entire team has worked very hard on it. And we have created some great content across all languages, films, regional, devotional. So that all hard work has paid off. You know, I mean, that's why we have got this. We have got acknowledgement from YouTube, means time and again, you know, because they have some system of acknowledging what you are achieving by giving some trophies and all these stuff. Yeah. So it's a very good feeling.
You know, I read and That this, of course, you took over the company under very tragic circumstances when you were only 19, right? And it was, you were pushed into it. I mean, I'm guessing that it wasn't something that at that point you had prepared for. So what is it you think, Bhushan, that has really enabled you to bring it here when you are the biggest? You know, what's the key to this success?
See, the thing is, when I took over the business, as you rightly said, I was not prepared for it at all. Means I was just in my second year BCom and doing my colleging, and this tragic thing happened to our
but
family.
But were you involved at all? Did you
work? No, not at
Bilkul
all. Ekdam nahi, means not even a bit.
You were going to college?
Yes, I was going to college, and my father used to pull me, you know, just come for the recording and see how the, you know, just to meet actors and all. I still remember I went for Dile Ke Mantani recording, which my father was producing with Bhatsab, and Amir Khan was there in that film. So I went for that muhurat of the song. You know, that time we used to do muhurat of the song also. It was a big event always, means
correct.
Then the first song of any film used to be recorded, you know, means you.
Yeah, yeah, of course, that. Of course.
It has happened in all the major films and all. So I used to go for those outings only.
No. But shock tha ki shock bhi nahi tha?
To be very frank, actually music ka shock tha, sunne ka, like every youngsters has that time, you know, means I still remember when Aashiqui album was coming out.
Yeah.
And you know, in those days we used to release album six months before the film release. We used to prepare the album because lakhs of cassettes used to be launched. So few, you know, 1-2 months before the preparations and everything used to start. So I still remember I was very fond of Maine Pyar Kiya album, and I used to listen to those songs. My father gave me this Aashiqui ka cassette. Okay, listen to this cassette. This is my best album till date which I have made. And this, I have a feeling that this will be the best album for the ages, for the times to come. And that's what has happened today. Actually, Aashiqui is the best selling album till date.
I remember doing a story on it for India Today magazine that it sold over 1 crore units.
That time. After that, means we have started, stopped counting, because
really?
During when I took over also, which was almost 7 years after the album was launched, we used to sell lakhs of cassettes every month.
That's amazing.
So it was a huge, huge thing which never used to stop. Means this was the, I think, only cassette which when jab ghis jati thi, people used to buy again.
Correct.
You know, means okay, yes. Abhi now it is not sounding well and all these stuff, so they used to do
it. Ek aur le lo.
So that thing used to happen. So my experience was that much only, means I was not involved in the process, the how my father used to make music. Like my father had great ear for music, so he used to select all the songs, and as every one of us know, he used to make many telefilms, you know, just keeping music in mind, Lal Dupatta Malmalka, Jeena Teri Gali Mein, Meera Ka Mohan, all these films are with great music, but films are made for the sake of it.
Correct.
So that's why I used to make, just call it telefilms and make the films just for music purpose only.
But how did you do it then, Bhushan? How did you, what do you think was the one factor?
See, one factor is, I always tell that because that's the truth, it's just, I've seen the passion and kind of, you know, if I call it jununiyat my father had for music. He used to eat, live, everything used to be music.
Really?
Every time he was listening to the songs, every time somebody or the other, because that time we didn't have WhatsApp and all these stuff. So he, every time music director used to come home, play him songs, music settings and all these stuff. Though I was not involved in those sitting, but I used to oversee, it means what's happening and all. So I've seen that, and I've seen my father telling my mother, you know, means like music is my life. Till the time music and this business is there, I'm always there. You know, and then my mother always used to say, okay, why are you saying all these things, you know, all the means. But he was very, very passionate about those things. My mother has told me, okay, this was his passion towards music. So that sort of thing, you know, means gave me and my entire group, because we have all the people who are working with me are
from 20
years.
Absolutely.
Like Neeraj Kalyan, Vinod Bhanushali, Mr. Ved Chandna, my mom, everybody, Gulshan Kumar, my uncle, they all are with me like pillars, you know, means from the beginning, from the time I have to cover. Today it's almost 21 years I've taken over the business, and we are doing very well.
You think it's the passion?
That thing means, you know, which my father said to my mom, okay, I am there till the time music, my company is there. So that thing gave us that inspiration, and I took over with, I used to cry also so many times when I took over because I didn't know anything about the business. And
it must have been overwhelming, no?
Yeah, means, yeah, but
so how do you do it?
But
you know?
See, that's what I always used to feel, that there is some power which is teaching me. That was, of course, my father, and how to overcome the problem, because we faced too many problems, because my father was responsible for everything. You know, that in those days, the income tax laws and excise duties and all these things were very, very tough. It was not easy. The taxation was 60% and above. Today it's 35%, but that time it was 60% and above. It was very, very difficult. Nothing was systematic to that extent. So it was very difficult to cope up with everything. Everything used to happen in relationships. At that, only my father had. Nobody else in my family had those relationships with the government officers and with the producers, everybody. So there was a, you know, reluctance in many people, means, you know, okay, how our music will be marketed. The man who had that touch is not there, and how you will market the music, you know. So I had to literally convince everyone, you know, I will be able to market because we'll be following everything what my father used to do, and he is with us. Means obviously this is our emotion, my family emotion, you know, okay, what we feel, okay, how he was supporting us by not being there physically with us. But we had to prove everybody by doing work, which we did. We marketed, I still remember my first marketed music was Aflatoon and Dule Raja, came very simultaneously and became very huge hit. The songs became, means it was everywhere. Films also became super hit. So from there I started gaining confidence. And then there was no stopping. I tested my ear for music. That was a very, very important thing, because till today, means I tell in my all interviews, when anybody asks how you select a song and how you have got great ear sense, I tell them that only. That is always inherent from my father, and he had great sense for music, and that has come to me. And to run a music label, this thing is very, very important. You can't hire this. You
Correct.
Can't. I can't hire. I can't hire a person who will have good ear sense. Everybody will say, I know how to make music. But I know in this industry, very few people have that great ear for music. And it's not easy. You have to be on your toes. You have to listen to all kind of music which is running in the market. You should be knowing ki which music is working on which platform. It's not only YouTube or one streaming site. It's all over. It's radio, it's television, it's award shows, it's discotheque. Every place report you must have to gain that ear for music. So which my father used to do the same, you know, that time. He used to go to parties just to listen to the music, what people
are playing.
Log kya chala rahe hain, DJs kya chala rahe
hain. Really?
You know, all these things, small thing he used to do.
Do you do that?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It means we have to do that. But otherwise you can't, and you know, this, like how if you want to become a singer, you have to do riyaz and all. For if you want to, you know, just get that,
develop your sense
every now and then with the time and again, means, you know, the kind of taste which keeps on changing and all these stuff. You have to be in the market and listening to what people are liking.
Do you have people on the ground? Because Bhushan, if you walk into a party, everyone knows who you are, right? So wo artist to bechara.
No, we have people. Means I have a team which I call a music team. They are on the run and they keep on getting these reports.
The feedback.
Yeah, feedback, and we accumulate that feedback, and then I match that with my ear sense, and that helps me a lot.
So tell me, what is the process, Bhushan, of, you know, green lighting an artist or green lighting a song or an album in T-Series? You know, how does it work?
See, for me, is the song. Obviously, you should have a good voice.
Right.
But is the song. Song melody is very, very, very important. And that melody is, even if you make a dance track, melody is important. Even if you make a sad track, melody is important. What I mean by melody? Melody is what you can hum. I always judge a song which I can, if I have heard it right now, I can hum it, you know.
And if you can't hum it?
Then I don't take that song.
Really?
That's the thumb rule which I have.
That's the bottom line.
That thing has helped me over the years. Today means the kind of music means I have made, means with all the other producers also, means there are many films which they welcome us to, you know, give our inputs in the songs. Whether it's the film which we have bought the music for, we are not the producer. So it's a great feeling, means people acknowledge your ear sense, and I have fulfilled, means, you know, by giving those kind of songs, every producer has gained out of it, and I've also gained out of it.
But Bhushan, is there a big difference between what you like personally and what the market, what goes, say, what sells in the market, or are you mostly on track?
I have forgotten my personal taste.
Really?
I don't listen to music which I like. I listen to music which people like.
But ye kaise hota hai? Like, how do you know ki people will like?
To run a music label, you have to listen to our songs, and you have to get your entertainment also. Like, music is an entertainment. So to entertain yourself, you should like what people are liking. And I'm telling you, means 90% of the people, there are very few people who will like weird stuff. That obviously I can't match that.
Right.
But 80 to 90% of the people want to hear what I'm talking about. I'm talking about simple melody, whether it's a dance number. Like, I made Suraj Dooba Hai song. You know, it has great melody. You can, if I hum it, you will also start humming it, because it's a very simple melody. But by adding beat to it, it becomes a dance track. If I add a soft beat to it, it will become a romantic track. So these are the things, and I can't have my just personal taste. I will definitely go wrong. I've come across many people in the industry which are opposite me. They say, no, I like this song.
Right.
If people are not liking, I care a damn. But that way you can't make great music
but
at all.
Which directors often tell me ki when they are making movies, right? When they're writing a story, there's no way to judge ki whether people will like it or not. So they say, we make what we love, because at least that way one person loves it. But you're saying ki that's not how the music world works?
I don't work that way. But obviously, yes, when I'm making a film, I have to justify the situation also. I can't say, okay, this is a commercial super hit song and it is not going in your situation, take it.
Right.
That never happens. So when that has to be done, sometimes the compromise has been made, you know. You have to make it very neutral. Okay, this is the song which people will like, to that extent. Some people will like, see, for every song there are some people at least. Means I'm not saying ke if I make a song which I feel ke 80%, there's a song which 80% of the people will like. There is a song which only 20% people will like. So sometime because of the situation restrictions and the film restriction, you make a song which is 20% which people will like.
You go with the less popular.
Yeah.
Because so, it fits the, so yes, the situation.
So sometime right. You have to compromise that way also.
Sure. But tell me, this brings me to a big question. Is it true that your father created the concept of the music bank, where music was stored and then sort of retrofitted into films or into videos?
Yeah, absolutely.
He created that?
Yes, he used to do that. First thing he did was the Aashiqui songs. Out of 8 Aashiqui songs, 4 was made by him when he went to Bhatsa to make a film. Hmm. You know, it was a very nice incident in which my father first time met Bhatt Saab, and this I know because we are making a film on him,
right.
Biopic on him. So this was a scene which is there in that, in which my father goes to Bhatt Saab and plays these 4 Aashiqui songs and say, I know how to make music, I don't know how to make films. So I want to make great films, produce with me and direct Aashiqui. So that was, this Bhatt Saab told us. So that time Bhatt Saab made this film. So you, as you rightly said, he used to make bank and give it to the producers and to the people whom he was working with as producer also, to put those songs into the film. And that time it was very easy. Means everybody used to always wanted 2 romantic songs,
huh.
1 dance track,
correct.
1 item song. You huh. know, that time it used to be called item song.
Right. But Bhushan, which is also something that has perhaps led to the idea of multiple composers in a film, because now there are banks of songs and you can just pick what you like, which of course many composers have a real problem with. You know, Pritam and Vishal Shekhar have spoken very, with a lot of sort of angst about what this does to a film. Or agar film mein retrofitting aap kar rahe hain, toh wo organic toh ho hi nahi sakta. What is your, idea? Have we lost something with this idea of banking, multiple composers?
See, I agree to their thing, means they have a thought process. But I disagree in some way also. Because today, the kind of work our producers are doing, I am doing, everybody cannot have Vishal Shekhar or Pritam.
Sure, sure. Yeah.
And plus is, to be very frank, means I have no problem saying on camera also, they have less time also because they are busy in shows. Earlier, Pritam or Vishal Shekhar, all the premium music director never used to do shows.
Right.
Today, they are very much involved, and I won't blame them because they earn great amount of money because of their popularity and their voice and the kind of songs they have. They make great amount of money. So that's the thing which is dividing the time. But yes, if the music directors are caliber and they are ready to give time, so there is no harm. It is better for the film also if we have one music composer in the film. But the reason of...
You're saying it is better for
yeah,
them.
But reason is today's time means I have to shoot the film, say, next month. I'm not getting songs from Pritam because he's busy. He's not able to give time to make 7 songs or 6 songs. So saying you take one song and then you take other songs, you should change your schedule and shoot it in the end and all these stuff doesn't go with the filmmaking. Mm. I mean, this though even we experienced in Sanju.
Yeah.
You know, Pritam was doing earlier and then again it was because of lack of time and his busy schedule and he was doing many films. So it didn't happen.
So you're saying the composers are also contributing to the situation?
Absolutely. Means if they say, no, we are not doing any shows, we are giving concentrated full time.
So to your film.
So we as producers, yeah. Today I'm not only the one, I'm the one of the earlier producer who have started doing this by taking mixed composer like in Aashiqui and all. Again, all these things happened because we were not getting enough time and content from the music director for one particular film. Full film, we were not getting those kind of songs. And obviously, in today's time, you have actors' dates, you have to shoot on in the on those particular dates. So we can't shift our schedule. It means we will shoot it after 1 month or 3 months or 4 months to shoot the composer.
Yeah.
It's not practical today. And that's why not me, everybody, means of the biggest of the film, people are going with mixed composer. A biggest film of our times today is Sanju, which is with mixed composers.
Yeah.
They also wanted to have a solo composer, but...
Ab nahi ho sakta.
Nahin, isi wajah se nahin ho paya. Means if you'll ask the producers, Raju ji and Vedu ji, they will also tell you the same thing, ke it was not because we didn't get time from
music director. Something is lost when you have multiple composers?
See, I don't think so, because I have given those kind of hits in multiple, there are many albums in which multiple composers are there and they are super duper hit, like Aashiqui.
Right.
We got all the best album awards, all my music director got. Then Yaariyaan, we got best music director award. Roy, we got best music director's award. And commercially also they have done well. So I don't think, yes, but if there is a particular film, you know, like, see, today we are making thrillers, we are making comedies. In that you don't actually need a solo composer, because it's the sur of the film is comedy. There is very less music in these kind of films. If you see comedy, they can't put more than 3 songs or 4 songs. If you see thrillers, they can't make more than 2 or 3 songs. So you need a composer in which it's a proper musical album, like Aashiqui. But I don't have any grudges on Aashiqui also, because Aashiqui is the number one album. Aashiqui 2, I'm saying.
Right. Kyunki tum hi ho, ab tum hi ho,
zindagi ab tum hi ho. It has multiple composers. Ae Dil Hai Mushkil, which was not our album, but it was a super successful album. It has Preetam in it. So
both work.
For both works. But yes, if you're making a proper musical album, in which if you have a composer who is one composer and he's ready to give full time to it, so that will be the better option.
You know, the other thing that often comes up is this sort of conversation about why are there so many remixes? You know, why are we in this age of what Javed Saab called creative vandalism, where we're just taking from the old and just rehashing Punjabi music or old film songs? Why aren't we creating enough original music?
See, one thing is, I don't create. I make music director create. At times, it's the quality of music which we want and which we are somehow getting not on time from the music directors and lyricists, and that's the reason this thing is coming. And the main reason is people wants to listen. Today's people, see, I tell you one song, Dil Mein Ho Tum, there's song Bhappi Leri song.
Huh.
It's a very famous song. And there was another Rajesh Khanna song, Dil Kya Kare.
Huh.
I played it to few youngsters. They thought it's a fresh song.
Right.
They didn't know it was an old song.
Of course.
And if I tell you these recreation songs, when they come up, 80% of the likability is there, 80%. Commercially, likability wise, and it helps the film also. So why there is so much of hue and cry about it, why this is being made? This is the flavor of the season. People wants to listen to the songs which they have not heard it, or which are in very low recording, which are in very different kind of format, which is in dholak, tabla, which people doesn't want to learn. They want to enjoy those songs in discotheques. So what is the harm in doing that?
But you know,
I fail to understand. Means this is everybody talks about this, why you are recreating songs. I'm not doing, everybody is doing.
Maybe.
All the major production houses, Dharma Productions.
Sure.
Everybody
sure.
is Everyone doing. It's not doing. Only me.
But you know, sometimes, Bhushan, like when I saw Ek Do Teen. Right, I just felt like,
I totally understand. There are some songs. See, that's what...
You shouldn't touch those.
That's what I have to, always mention in... recreating is an art.
Hmm.
It is a very, very important part when you are recreating a song. Okay, you should always recreate a song when you can recreate it better. If you don't have that taste, if you don't have that ability to judge that this is better than the original, then you shouldn't touch it.
Right.
That's the thing which you are talking about. It's absolutely correct. There are songs which people recreate and they mess it up completely. And there are many songs like that. I can't mention it because many are with my company because the producers have taken the rights from me and done it. And I can't say much about that.
You know, the other thing, Bhushan, that often comes up in conversations about T-series is that because you are such a giant, it's almost like a monopoly, right? And you control what we are listening to, you control which artist becomes popular, you can actually just bombard the market and streaming platforms in such a way that you can actually make the song a hit. What is your response to that?
That's a plus point for us. Means we are very aggressive in marketing across all platforms. We don't have any enmity with any platform. Ke our song will not run on this channel or that channel or this streaming site. There are many other companies which have problems with many other people. So we go on that formula, and it's not the okay, we are the giant or we have the power to do it. It's the ability to market the music, and that's the reason every producer who comes to us, they tell us that you are genius in marketing. Because we are genius in marketing, our placements of songs are there everywhere. And plus the important thing goes to our catalog, which over the years my father created and then I created. That plays a very, very important role. Today, if you put a song on any YouTube channel, same song you put it on our channel and put a song on other channel, the difference is 1:10.
Of course.
Means if you have 1 lakh views in one particular channel, in our channel it will be 1 million views. So that's the difference, that's the platform, that's the power of content which we have generated over the years. And that helps us in all the way to market any new product which comes in and to be popular all over the world in a proper way.
But Bhushan, you never use this power to, let me use the word, to bully artists?
Not bully artists, they get attracted.
Do they have freedom?
Yes, absolutely. They have freedom. Freedom in what sense?
In their creative sense, can they create what they love and what they like?
Absolutely, they create what they love, and means I would say 70% of the times, many artists are bang on, and who are not, we guide them, change this, change that. And we both are on consensus and we work in that fashion.
But if push comes to shove, Bhushan, who has final cut? You know, in a movie, final cut is often studios have it and not directors. In T-series, who has it? You
or
the artist?
For the music? For the music, it is mutual. Means sometimes I compromise and I tell the artist, I don't like that song to that capacity, but you want to do it, let's do it. So sometimes, as I told you, that I have 90% of the year sense which means my team, we have generated over the years. But sometimes that 10% takes over, and sometimes we are wrong also. There are examples in which artist was telling me, let's do this song. I was saying, no, this song won't be good, won't do that much. So he said, no, trust me and do it, sir. So I'm like, okay, theek, we'll do it. And that sometimes he is correct, sometimes I'm correct.
Right.
So it is always mutual. But most of the times, yes, we are mutually, we get okay on the song and whenever we are doing.
Now you're, of course, not now, for many decades you've been, but now it's really sort of come to the forefront is you're also a massive producer.
Yeah.
T-Series, I read, is investing 500 crores this year into making movies. Is
absolutely
that correct?
Absolutely, yes. We have already actually, we are producing major films like Bharat is with Salman Bhai and Atul and Ali Abbas. And then we are doing Sahu. It's a very big budget South film with Prabhas. Then we are doing a dance film with Varun and Katrina. That's also a 100 crore plus film. And we are doing a film with Ajay Devgan. Sorry, three films with Ajay Devgan. The third one is with Ranbir Kapoor, with Lav Ranjan is directing. So if you sum up this, it will go beyond 500, I guess.
But you said that I'm a hands-on producer and I'm tough on budgets. You said I am not going to just sort of give a director freedom because of just passion. So, Bhushan, do you think there needs
no,
to...
No, sometime I have... Now I have changed,
you,
yes.
You have changed?
I just did it in Sonu Ki Titu Ki Sweetie, in which they were relatively newcomers. I mean, they were not very, very big artists that time. And my director and my partner, Love Ranjan, he wanted to shoot the song big. He wanted to spend more money. So he went overboard by 30-40% of the budget, which is huge, which I never ever allow. But I saw the passion.
Did you say yes?
But I saw the passion in him and the kind of things he told me. He means it is on me. He said, ke, aap mere liye kar dijiye and I am there with you. Obviously, we are doing so many things together. So you recover wherever if this film doesn't work. But his conviction was so strong ke I said, okay, chalo, we'll do it. So we did it and we were successful. The over budget came back. There were a lot of profit also, which he also generated, I also generated. And that has strengthened our relationship. Now we are doing all the films together.
So it worked out.
Yeah.
That risk worked out.
Yeah.
How do you pick movies?
Earlier, you know, people used to accuse us ke yaar aap sirf picture wo lete ho jisme music is there. But we changed that with a film called Airlift, Baby, and so many films we did in which music was not the benchmark of Raid. Recently we did Raid, which music was not the backdrop of it.
Absolutely.
If we get great music, one or two songs, it's fine. If not, it's okay. Because earlier we were just, as I told you, ke means our thinking was that we are making movies for music. Today we are not making movies for music. We are making movies, and if it has scope for music, then definitely we'll put great music. Otherwise, we'll just go without music or one theme song or whatever it is. So music is not very, very important that way. So people get attracted towards us today because of this thought which we have changed. It means if they come to us, we will not force them to put music. Kya music dalo. So we are concentrating properly, independently
on stories,
on films and content. Great content is what we are looking at. And we again, like music, we keep on judging our sensibility for that. We chose Hindi medium, which did so well. We chose Tumhari Sullu, which did very well. Kind of films which are coming up now, those are also all content-driven films. And some are with music, some are without music, but the content is there.
And of course, in your roster of directors is your wife, Divya.
Yeah.
I read an interview she did where she said that when she first told you she wanted to make a movie, you didn't allow her to assist any other directors. Why?
No, I didn't allow aisa nahi. It means she wanted to do a movie and she learnt about it. She did many music videos. She experienced there. She learned how to, you know, means filmmaking. And then she came up with one idea called Yaariyaan, and he did it and she did a great job and I was very happy about it.
And you put some really sort of saleable music in
yeah,
Yaariyaan,
yeah,
and it became
it,
a big
yes,
success.
Yes.
You know, you're a sort of more reticent personality, but she's very active on social media, and so I've seen all the pictures of your latest holiday in Tuscany and all. Are you comfortable with that kind of exposure? Does she ask you before posting?
Yeah, she asks me, but I'm comfortable with
you're
that.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not on social media because I don't have time at all means for this thing. Yes, but many people are not on social
of course,
media. So
of course.
I'm okay with it if she is doing it.
You're comfortable.
And now she wants to experience in acting also. Like I've seen her some stuff, so she's great in that. So now she is going to do a few films as an actor, means meaningful role and all these stuff. So she's very excited about that.
And you're a supportive husband.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
What are your three top songs?
See, my three top songs are actually Aashiqui song. Means my one is Tu Meri Zindagi Hai.
Meri Zindagi Hai Tu Meri Har Khushi Hai.
And then again Tumhi Ho from Aashiqui 2. And then Sanam Re title track.
Sanam Re Tu Mera Sanam Hua Re Sanam Re Sanam Re.
These are my three major track which I love. But mostly I don't listen to old song means which are released songs because I have so much to listen to the new ones.
You're always listening to new
yeah,
songs.
Yeah, new ones which are not released.
And how do you discover new artists?
See, many artists come to us Like recently, I don't want to name because he's just a very new artist. He came up and he played me three songs, and I selected those three songs as blockbuster to me.
Really?
And now I want to see when I release it, it becomes blockbuster or no.
But how did I get to you?
Which I surely feel it will be blockbuster will be. Because in the past also this has happened many times, and always, as I told you, 90-95% time we are always correct on that.
But how does, if I'm a music composer in Mumbai, how do I get to Bhushan Kumar?
See, the thing is, it's not easy, obviously, because there are so many people who wants to get into music, get into singing. So everybody meeting me, it's not possible. Everybody meeting my team is also not possible because so many of them are there. But yes, whoever approaches us means through email, through our Facebook, through our Twitter, means
that's the way to do it.
Absolutely. See,
so
today
if they tweet at T series, somebody will respond.
Absolutely. We keep on getting so many inquiries on our Facebook, on our website, on Twitter account. Everywhere means, and we there is a team who always respond to them, meet them, and keep on doing. And plus, many people means, you know, they come to us in office also, and they meet my team during parties and all. Even in the shopping mall, people come to me.
You don't get irritated? And,
no, I'm fine with it. It's my work, so I'm very comfortable about that. To listening to a good, because I don't want to miss to that particular song which will be a blockbuster.
This is good to know. If anyone sees you in a shopping mall, then they should come and run up to you.
Which song was there? There was one song which just came to me randomly from somewhere. It was Vaja Tumo. There was a song called Vaja Tumo in a film of ours, Hit Story 3. So it came from a random person, you know, it just came on our in my email ID, and I heard this song and I said, it's a super hit song, let's take it. And that song has 300 million views today.
Wow.
So we called him, we took that song, recorded it and put it in the film right away. Where other people were doing the music, established music directors were doing the songs, but we put it in this, and they were asking me, who is this person? I said, it's not a person, it's a song. So that thing we never want to miss. Anyone who has great music, but there are many people who we can't help about it, because everybody is struggler, everybody wants to work hard, but sometimes they're not able to convince us in terms of great melody.
So Bhushan, I know you have an empire to run, and I have kept you from it long enough, but I have one last question. You are in a position of immense power. You know, you can change so many things. What is the one thing that you really want to do?
See, I really want to fulfill my father's dream, which was music, of course, and which his blessings, I have tried to do what I could do best with the help of my team. And his next big thing was films. That I've just started 2 years back, and I want to make him proud on this thing also, means film thing, because it was his dream. I still remember, as I just told you, means he went to Bhatsap. I don't know how to judge a film, I know how to judge songs. So that thing I'm taking it to next level, and which quite successful we have been over the last year. And now we are hoping in coming years also we take it to next level.
And do you have any plans for the larger ecosystem of cinema, of music? You know, do you ever want to sort of mentor new artists or create a school?
See, we have a music school in Delhi, T-Series Stage Works, where we teach music, we make singers. And we have released a couple of singers on our YouTube channel also. And that thing we are doing. And plus our thought process is, now we are adding it to acting academy also.
So you will nurture new talent.
Yeah, that will be there. And plus we keep on adding new talent to our system. Like we took over, we got Arman Malik. He's doing so well. He started with when he used to do shows for 2 lakh rupees. once in a month. Today he's doing 7-8 shows at 30 lakh rupees. So it's an achievement which we all have. He has worked hard. We have worked hard. Our team has worked hard and we have done it. Plus, the same way Zubain Nautiyal is there. We have taken him and we are taking him to next level. So many new artists who are coming up to us who have great voice, great melody, because these days music singer comes and they know how to compose also. So it's two in one and it helps us also. Obviously, all of them are not those talented enough, but many of them are, and we are mentoring them and taking them to next level.
Super. Thank you and all best for all the music you're going to create and the movies.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, if you like this video, subscribe to Film Companion.